It's a beautiful day.
Right, Gordon Drummond, welcome to Leggett & Co. I'm here with the Scotland skipper. Big selections of the last week for Scotland. You got a game Monday. Do you want to just talk about through the new players to the team?
Half of it's been forced upon us, with obviously losing Kyle down to Northants on loan, and Mr. Watts, who's around here at this moment in time, with his broken finger. So we've got two of the youngsters coming into the squad, but they've played before, so they're not new to it, and they've put in some good performances in the past and totally deserved of their place. I'm sure they'll enjoy playing at the Rose Bowl. Also got a new keeper in Craig Wallace, very, very talented player, and hopefully he'll shine the weekend and enjoy his game and kick on and be a big part of us in the future.
Strong team going into the last game of the CB40. The tour to Namibia, that was selected. Do you want to talk us through that? You've got three different teams, the 4-day, the 1-day and the 2020.
Yeah, obviously you've got guys of different strengths coming in different formats of the game. Although there will be a core set of players there for every format, so and, you know, and the senior players in there as well, and hopefully performing. I think it's a really tough tour for us. Namibia have done well in recent games against Ireland, and have shown their calibre, and have got a strong squad. And it's always difficult when you're going into a team's home patch. We've done well in the 4-day format in the past. You know, we got to the final last year against Afghanistan. Fortunately, lost out, but. You know, we've got high hopes in that format again this year. I think we're still trying to find our best team for T20, and that's what these tours are about. You know, I've got Seddy in the background here trying to be funny, hence the word trying, because he struggles a lot of the time. He's actually poor in the dressing room, but we'll not talk about that. So I think we're still trying to find our best T20 team, and that's why we're playing five games in this series. And the ODIs as well, I think we've done well in our recent three ODIs against Holland and Ireland, and hopefully that can continue.
Very good. Just a quick comment on the Leggett & Co sponsored player Tyler Buchan, who's made it into the T20 squad. What can you say about him?
Yeah, he's a good player. He's a good player. His record's phenomenal in league cricket and the regional series as well, so that's he's fully deserved of his place. And hopefully he can do your sponsorship. Do it proud when he's playing in the Jocks team.
Fantastic. Yeah, so who's, if you want to pick out a few players that have just done exceptional for this year and really progressed Scotland up the rankings?
Momsen, you know, it's his first full year in the squad, and last year maybe struggled a little bit up front, you know, opening the batting. But we changed him, changed his position this year, and it looks like it's worked out. You know, he's batted really, really well, and he's come in there, total free spirit in the middle order there, and showed his class in the games. And obviously, you know, for a wee guy, he hits the ball powerfully and showed his power hitting in most games. That's put him up there in the top 10 in the CB40, you know, most valuable players, so I can't deny that. Sharif's done well since he's come in. Maka had a good year up until now, and so did and Fraser Watts as well. He's played superbly well and up the order there. And then, you know, we've been very lucky to have Kyle in the last few games as well, and he's got a strong head on his shoulders, and scoring that 100 against Northants, you know, paved the way for a great victory there as well. So I actually think that all the guys have contributed. You know, and probably, you know, he never really gets his praises sung, but Madge as well, he performs unbelievably well week in, week out for us, and obviously he's also scored 100 for us batting three, thrown up in the deep end, so to speak, against Holland in the 4-day and got 100 as well, so that shows the ability that he's got. And I think just all-round team spirit and has helped as well. You know, we've got a real good team spirit amongst the guys at the moment, and that's certainly shows when we're playing the games, and it helps us across the line, you know, in those tough encounters that we've had.
What game stands out the most this summer?
Definitely the Irish game. They have dominated in the last few years. We've got to be honest about that. They've dominated associate cricket, and obviously done really well against the full member nations as well. And that's kind of like they've set the bar for all the other associates, and beating them, and kind of the way the game was played as well. Chasing down 320 at the Grange is a great effort by the guys, and it was also a phenomenal effort by Richie Benton at the end there, 50 odd off 20 balls, which sealed the game, the win for us. And I think, yeah, I don't think any of the guys that played in that match for us will forget that.
Who's the person you least likely to sit next to on the plane?
On the plane?
Yeah.
Probably Juddy. Yeah, his chat is poor and he smells a bit as well, so probably Judd will stay away from him. It would have been Neil McCallum beforehand, because he's an absolute pest. but I'm glad he's retired.
Fantastic. So who's got the best chat, the diamond chat in the squad?
I'm trying to think who's going on tour. Certainly not Flanagan. Momsen doesn't really say much. Probably Majid Haq. Great chat.
Fantastic. Right.
Really mean McLeod, but he likes to talk about himself all too much, so.
Fantastic. It's a beautiful day.